The challenge is, and I had a conversation with a CEO recently who said, we collect every bit and byte of data there is. We just don't know which bit and byte of data we should be looking at. I think you have to break it down and really look at what is it that you're trying to figure out and simplify that analysis.
The marketplaces has gone from 22% to 36%. Again, it's not traffic, it's the sales. Part of that is because the marketplaces themselves have just gotten bigger and done a better job of bringing traffic, but there's also kind of a self-fulfilling prophecy going on in that in many cases, as more and more merchants come into these marketplaces and sell on them, they create a greater center of gravity. So consumers now can find more and more of their needs on a given website.
The customers, and we're all customers ourselves, and we shop at retailers, but we do it with a lot of digital. You know, recently we just surveyed our email customers and we asked them what channels they shopped in. So these are email customers, the people we talk to via a digital means, and 92% of them said they shop in the stores.
Sure.
Not only in the stores, they shop in both, but 92%. So only 8% of the people on our list only shopped online.
Obviously, the consumer has sort of changed the game for us here. So our position here is that, you know, retailers really have to take a clue from the past where we were focused on, you know, store and merchants and location and not lose that, but understand now that the focus can't just be about product and stores. It really is focused on the customer and their personalized experience. It's almost like getting back to basics, if you will. And I think we're at a point where we can really do that and deliver an experience to this customer that they want. Because this is what the shopper journey looks like today.